You know, the documentary to me has always been the big eye that gets the big sight and tells the truth and gets right to it and is there for history's sake. And now that more people are able to pick up a camera and, you know, get to a small band that existed in Kentucky for 3 years, I've got all the records. But the fact that someone interviewed the band before the one guy dies or whatever, that to me is the real heroic stuff.
And it's interesting because I've made films where I've had 3,000 hours of footage, and then I've made films like, here, we're segueing right now to the first clip.
Yes.
Hank Williams. You know, Hank Williams, there's 9 minutes of footage that exists of Hank Williams.
Right.
And I made a 90-minute film about him. And so it was the exact opposite challenge. You know, today, you can't even imagine Hank Williams or somebody like Robert Johnson existing today, because they existed in a time where they were almost ghosts in their own day. And certainly by the time they died, they became heavily mythologized. And that kind of, that was the big challenge with making Hank Williams.
Yeah.
So, you know, we could talk about it. I mean, I, early on in my career, I decided I wanted to make these music kind of history documentaries. And, you know, my heroes were people like Peter Guralnick and Grail Marcus and Stanley Booth and these great music writers who just blew my mind with their incredible stories. And I was making films about the Brill Building, about Muddy Waters, and Hank Williams. And Hank Williams' Honky Tonk Blues, I finished it 11 years ago. And to me, it was this great effort of journalism, really, to kind of rescue the real man, one of the most heavily mythologized figures in music.
Absolutely.
From history before everybody died. And I, other than one or two people, the biographer who's in the film, who worked with me on it, everybody else in the film knew Hank personally.
Yeah.
And that was really important to me because, you know, nobody even could get a sense of who that actual person was. And so I was just trying to grasp that before it disappeared into the ether. And that was a great challenge. And now virtually everybody in the film has died. You know,
yeah, there's people there who are, you don't know whether they're going to make it to the end of the
interview.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, there's some people who are...
Some didn't.